Meth lab busts, while not unheard of in the Brazos Valley, are definitely not a common sight. But what may be even more shocking is how many chances some criminals get. News 3's Alex Villarreal investigates the man arrested in connection with Friday afternoon's discovery of a meth lab in Bryan. And Alex, this is not the first time this man has been in trouble with the law.
No, it's not, Meredith. And unfortunately, some people have to learn things the hard way. And Jose Mireles is no exception. He was actually tased before being taken into custody Friday. And after taking a closer look at his rap sheet, we found this is nowhere near his first run-in with the law.
Thank the Lord that they got him.
Bryan residents were surprised when they had to be rushed out of their homes in the Villa West apartment complex. That shock quickly turned to disbelief when they found out the reason why. A meth lab. 33-year-old Jose Mireles and two women were found inside an apartment that neighbors say they had only been living in for 2 weeks when Brazos County constables discovered materials used to most likely make meth. Mireles has a long history of crime. He was convicted and sentenced to 20 years in the Texas Department of Criminal Justice in 2005 after pleading guilty to 4 counts of manufacturing and delivering a controlled substance. Sources say he only ended up doing time for about 3.5 years. He was paroled in early 2009. Mireles is now in violation of his parole and, since getting out early, has been arrested for burglarizing a home and evading arrest. He is now charged with a second-degree felony, possession of chemicals with the intent to make a controlled substance. His bond has been set at $10,000. But if he posts bail this time, it won't matter, because the TDC is holding him because he violated the conditions of his parole.
And some of you might be wondering about the 3 strikes and you're out law. We do have one in Texas, but this rule does not apply in this case because Mireles has only had to serve jail time once. The district attorney's office says that he can still face a minimum of 15 years. Live in the news center, Alex Villarreal, News 3.
And the DA's office is now looking at proving that some of his prior offenses are in conjunction with his most recent charges. And depending on the outcome, it could bump up his charge to a first-degree felony.